Today you're going to talk to us about another explosion of information in the history of life, more proof for intelligent design if you want, one that doesn't just challenge chemical evolutionary theories of the first life, but also Darwin's theory of biological evolution itself, which he formulated to explain the origin of all subsequent forms of life. So let me start with this. What is that evidence? What is the Cambrian explosion?
Well, the Cambrian explosion refers to the abrupt appearance of most of the major animal groups called the phyla, the largest division of animal life, representing novel body plans in a very narrow window of geologic time. So we have lots of fossils in the fossil record. The famed trilobites are one of the most distinctive or iconic fossils of this Cambrian period. But there are many other animal forms that arose in that period of time, and they did so very abruptly without evidence of ancestral precursors. The transitional intermediates are missing. You have this abrupt appearance.
Yeah, let me interpret, okay? Folks, if you go into the ground, all right, what he's talking about is you go down far enough, you're going to finally come to the fact of nothing, no animals at all. When you came to the Cambrian explosion, these are the first animals that showed up. What was the problem with them showing up the way they did?
Well, they didn't show up in a manner that matched what Darwin anticipated about the history of life. Darwin depicted the history of life as a great branching tree, where every form of life emerged gradually from a slightly simpler version, going back all the way to the first living cell. So you start with that first living cell, it morphs and changes, and you gradually get more and more complex forms of life until eventually, through a long gradual process, a series of gradations, you produce the first animals, the complex animals. But in the fossil record, we don't see the gradations. We just see those animal forms arising very abruptly without evidence of prior
That's what we're calling the Cambrian explosion.
They call it an explosion.
It just showed
right.
up.
Right. And it's not the only such explosion like this in the history of life. Many, many of the new life forms come into existence, the first birds, the first mammals, the first flowering plants, in this explosive manner. And so this is what we should expect on Darwin's theory, is a tree-like picture, but we don't have the little blue dots underneath. We only have the gold dots, if you will.
And the gold dots should be, it's like Darwin's tree of life. You start off with simpler molecules and you branch out into more complex. And the fact that when you look at the different animals that showed up, these guys didn't have any precursors in front of
and
them.
And they're already very
they're
complex.
They're already complex.
They're tightly integrated anatomical systems, multiple systems. The trilobites there on the end had compound eyes, very similar to modern insect eyes. Very sophisticated organs already present in these animals from the very beginning. So it's not simple to complex, it's complex from the beginning.